A branch shall sprout from the root of Jesse, and the glory of the Lord will fill the whole earth, and all flesh will see the salvation of God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, and with your spirit. I welcome you to Mass on the 20th of December in this greater Advent, the O Antiphons counting us down to the Nativity. O Clavis David, O Key of David, open wide the heavenly home. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
You are the good shepherd leading us to eternal life.
Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy.
You open for your people the way from death into life.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Let us pray.
O God, eternal majesty, whose ineffable word the Immaculate Virgin received through the message of an angel, and so became the dwelling place of divinity, filled with the light of the Holy Spirit, grant, we pray, that by her example we may in humility hold fast to your will. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, for ever and ever. Amen. A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The Lord spoke to Ahaz and said, ask the Lord your God for a sign for yourself, coming either from the depths of Sheol or from the heights above. No, Ahaz answered, I will not put the Lord to the test. Then Isaiah said, listen now, house of David, are you not satisfied with trying the patience of men without trying the patience of my God too? The Lord himself, therefore, will give you a sign. It is this, the maiden is with child, and will soon give birth to a son, whom she shall call Emmanuel, a name which means God is with us. Let the Lord enter, he is the King of glory. Let the Lord enter, he is the King of glory. The Lord is the earth and its fullness, the world and all its peoples. It is he who set it on the seas, on the waters he made it firm. Let the Lord enter, he is the King of glory. Who shall climb the mountain of the Lord? Who shall stand in his holy place? The man with clean hands and pure hearts, who desires not worthless things. Let the Lord enter. He is the King of glory. He shall receive blessings from the Lord and reward from the God who saved us. Such are the men who seek him, seek the face of the God of Jacob. Let the Lord enter. He is the King of glory.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Key of David, who opened the gates of the eternal kingdom, come to liberate from prison the captive who lives in darkness. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. The angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph,
of the house of David,
and the
virgin's name was Mary.
He went in and said to her, rejoice, so highly favoured, the Lord is with you. She was deeply disturbed by these words and asked herself what this greeting could mean. But the angel said to her, Mary, do not be afraid, you have won God's favour. Listen, you are to conceive and bear a son, and you must name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his ancestor David. He will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and his reign will have no end. Mary said to the angel, "But how can this come about, since I am a virgin?" "The Holy Spirit will come upon you," the angel answered, "and the power of the Most High will cover you with its shadow. And so the child will be holy and will be called Son of God. Know this too, your kinswoman Elizabeth has in her old age herself conceived a son, and she whom people called barren is now in her sixth month, for nothing is impossible to God." "I am the handmaid of the Lord," said Mary. "Let what you have said be done to me." And the angel left her. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Most. May Almighty God accept the sacrifices from my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for all good and good of all his holy church. Look, O Lord, we pray upon the one sacrifice of your Son, that by participating in this mystery we may possess at last the gifts we have awaited, and for which our faith bids us hope. Through Christ our Lord.
The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts, we lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenis concedia terra, gloria tua, hosanna in excelsis, benedictus, qui venit in nomine Domini, hosanna in excelsis.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Richard our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember your servant Noreen Cornes, whom you have called from this world to yourself, while that she who is united with your Son in the death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
For O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen.
At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," but not in our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always, and with your spirit.
On your stay, we've always had our time on thee, miserable.
the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. The angel said to Mary, behold, you will conceive and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. Let us pray. Grant divine protection, O Lord, to those you renew with this heavenly gift, that to those who delight in your mysteries, you may give the joy of true peace through Christ our Lord. Amen. Public Mass tomorrow, 10 a.m, Tuesday, here in St. Mary Magdalene. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God.